Dear friends, welcome to another Python coding tutorial. Today we are going to build a script that takes an animated GIF icon and turns it into a Sprite Sheet image where every sprite is placed in a row, one after another. Believe it or not, we can achieve that with just 18 lines of code. I needed this tool to help me load animations on my embedded projects, and Sprite Sheets are needed to achieve it. Sprite Sheets are also very useful in game development. So, by building this project, you are going to learn the basics of image manipulation in Python while creating a useful and practical program. If this sounds interesting, let's start. Let's first consider the problem we are trying to solve and divide it into more manageable components. Our goal is to take an animated GIF icon and convert it into a Sprite Sheet bitmap image. An animated GIF icon consists of many frames, and by displaying them fast enough, we deceive the human eye into seeing a continuous animated image. A Sprite Sheet image, on the other hand, is an image that contains all the frames one after another. This way, we can load the image once and then extract the individual frames easily, without the need to load them separately. If the icon is a complex one and contains a lot of frames, we can save a lot of memory by using a Sprite Sheet. We are going to build a Python script that will open an animated GIF icon. It will extract all the frames of it one after another. It will resize them if needed, and it will paste them one after another into a new image file before saving it as a bitmap file. So the steps we need to take to create our program are the following. Install the pillow module, open the GIF image, get the image size and the number of frames, create a new blank Sprite Sheet image, extract the frames one by one, resize the frames if needed, paste the frames into the Sprite Sheet image, and lastly, save the Sprite Sheet image as a BMP file. Now that we know what we need to do, it's time to start coding. We are going to use the pillow module to open, extract, resize, and save our images. To install it, we open the terminal or the command line or the PowerShell and we type the following command, pip install pillow. This command will download and install the pillow module, which is a fork of the PIL Python image library module. Now, let's create a new Python project folder. Let's name it GIF to Sprite Sheet, for example. Inside this folder, let's create a blank main.py file to contain the code of the script, and let's place a GIF icon inside this folder. Let's add an animated rain icon and name it rain.gif. Now, let's open the main.py file and import the image class we are going to work with. We type from PIL import image with a capital I. Now let's run the program to see if everything works so far. Cool, the program runs without errors, so the pillow module is installed correctly and it is ready to be used. Step number one is now complete. That was easy. Let's move to step number two. We want to open the image and get some information about it. In this case, we want to know its size and the number of frames it has. The first thing we need to do is to open the image. In this project, we are going to work exclusively with the image class we imported. This class has a lot of methods and attributes. It has all we need for this project. The image class has a method named open, which opens an image file and returns an image object. So we type image.open parentheses, and we enter the GIF image we want to open. As we saw earlier, our GIF image is named rain.gif, and it is located in the same folder as the Python script, so we just enter rain.gif in quotes here. Since this method returns an image object, let's save it into a variable and call it GIF, for example. If we now run the script, we can see that it runs without errors, but it does not show anything on the screen or the console. If we want to see the image we loaded, we can call the show method of the image class. Let's try it. GIF.show. This method converts the image object into a temporary PNG file and opens it with the default image viewer of our computer. Our image is an animated icon, but it appears static. And that's because the show method took the first frame of the animated GIF icon and converted it into a PNG file. We don't need this method in our project, so we can remove it, but it helped us see that the open method works. Let's now create a variable to hold the file name to open to make our code more versatile. File name is equal to rain.gif, and inside the open method, we just enter the file name variable, just like this. Step number 2 is now complete. Let's move on. Okay, so far we have opened the image file. Now we are going to see some of the attributes of that image object we have created. The image class offers a lot of useful attributes. As you can see, we can get the file name, the format, the mode, and many more things. We are only interested in a couple of things about this image. We want its size in pixels and the number of frames it contains. To get the size of the image, we use the size attribute. It returns a tuple with the width and the height of the image in pixels. Let's try it. Print gif.size. As you can see, it outputs a tuple containing two values, 192, 192. That's the width and the height of the GIF image. Let's make this print statement a little bit better. Print f image size, curly brackets, GIF size. To get the number of frames the image contains, we can use the nFrames attribute. So we type print f frames, curly brackets, gif.nFrames. As you can see, if we run the script, it tells us it contains 35 frames. Cool, our code works. We have completed step number 3. We have made a lot of progress. By the way, if you find this video useful so far, consider giving it a like, so more people can learn about it and show me that I'm producing useful content. Thanks a lot. It's time to move on to step number 4. We are going to create a new blank Sprite Sheet image. Before creating the new blank image, let's think about its dimensions. The user may want to change the height and the width of the output file. So let's create a new variable named output size to hold the new dimensions for each frame of the output file. The user may want to set the height and the width of each tile to a value that is smaller or bigger than the original size of the frame. Let's say we want to reduce the size of each frame from 192 by 192 pixels to 50 by 50 pixels to fit in this small OLED screen. So let's store the dimensions in a tuple, like this. The new image is going to be a blank image, and it's going to contain all the frames of the animated GIF icon, one after another. The image class has a method to create a new blank image. It is named new, and it accepts a couple of arguments, the mode and the size of the new image. Pillow supports many image modes. We are going to use the RGB mode because we want our new image to be a color image with no transparency. If we wanted to create a black and white image, we would use the one mode, which creates a monochrome image. The size of the new image needs to be a tuple, containing the width and the height of the image. We know that the width of the new image needs to be equal to the width of the output frame multiplied by the number of frames it contains, because we want to place each frame next to each other. The height of the output image does not change. We only have a single row of frames. Let's think of it this way. If the size of each frame is 50 by 50 pixels and the animated GIF icon contains 35 frames, the size of the new image needs to be 50 times 35 pixels by 50 pixels. So the width of the new image will be 1550 pixels and the height 50 pixels. We have all we need to create the new blank image. Let's create a new variable named Sprite Sheet to hold the new blank image object. We type Sprite Sheet is equal to image.new parentheses quotes RGB comma parentheses output size 0 times GIF n frames comma output size 1. And we run the script. Nothing happens. Is something wrong? Let's see. The new method creates a new image object that we are saving in the Sprite Sheet variable. All we need to do is to display the Sprite Sheet object on the screen, just like we did with the GIF object earlier. So we type spritesheet.show. And we see a new blank image with the size we specified. Step number 4 is now complete. We have created the new blank image that is going to contain the frames. Let's remove this line of code, we don't need it anymore. It is time to move on to step number 5. We are going to extract the frames from the GIF image one after another and paste them into the blank Sprite Sheet image. How are we going to do that? If we take a look at the documentation of the image class, we can see that it has a few methods that are useful for us. We are going to use two methods, seek and paste. The seek method allows us to get to a given frame of the animated GIF icon. This way, we can extract the frames one by one. The paste method allows us to paste an image on top of one another. To extract each frame, we are going to use a for loop. We are going to start with the first frame of the GIF image and end with the last frame of the GIF image. For frame in range 0, GIF.nFrames, colon. In this loop, we take advantage of the fact that we know how many frames the GIF image contains to define the start and the end value of the loop. Now we need to select a frame. We do so with the seek method. So inside the loop, we just type GIF.seekFrame. With this line of code, we select each frame of the GIF one after another until the last one. Now that we have selected each frame, let's resize it and save it into a new variable. Let's create a new variable called extractedFrame. Now we have to resize the selected frame. For this, we are going to use the resize method of the image object. Resizing the image is done by giving a new tuple inside the resize method. Remember that the width must come first and then the height. We are going to use the values we have saved in our variable named outputSize, so it is easy to change them if we want to. So, extracted frame is equal to gif.resize parenthesis output size. Just like this, we now have a resized extracted frame from the GIF file in memory. Another step is now complete. Very cool. Now, all we have to do is to paste the extracted frame into the Sprite Sheet image object we have created. For this, we are going to use the paste method. It takes two arguments. The first one is the image we want to paste. So we type spritesheet.paste parenthesis extracted frame, comma. The second argument is the position of the frame inside the Sprite Sheet image, a tuple of two values, the x and y coordinates in the blank file. The x and y coordinates start at 0 at the top left corner of the image and increase from left to right and from top to bottom. We want each frame next to each other in a row. So we want to paste the first frame at position 0, 0. The second one must be next to it, so it will be at 50, 0. Since each frame is now 50 pixels wide, the third must be at 100, 0, and so on. How can we specify this position? We could hard code it, but that's not a good idea in our case. We want the user to be able to change the output size, and then we want the Sprite Sheet image to adjust automatically. So what's the best way to do this? That's right, using a variable. So let's do it. We are going to create a new variable named position and we are going to write this inside the variable. Parenthesis, frame asterisk output size 0, 0. Output size 0 is the width of the frame, so each frame will be next to each other. Now, all we have to do is to place this expression inside the paste method of the Sprite Sheet image object we have created earlier. We just type position here, and one more step is complete. The last step is to save the Sprite Sheet image we created in the for loop. If we don't do this, it will be lost when the for loop ends. Let's save the Sprite Sheet image as a BMP file. To save an image object as a file, we are going to use the save method. The save method is very simple. We just have to give it a file name as an argument with a supported extension. So outside the for loop, we type spritesheet.save parentheses spritesheet.bmp, for example, and now we are done. The script is now complete. We can run it to see what happens. It takes the rain GIF icon we created earlier, it extracts its frame of it, it resizes them, and it creates a new Sprite Sheet file. We named it spritesheet.bmp. Let's open it to see the result. As you can see, all the frames of the rain GIF icon are now contained in this new image. We can use this image to load the frames in our embedded project one by one and create some cool animations. You can find the code of this project in a link in the video description. This was our Python coding tutorial on how to turn a GIF icon into a spreadsheet image using the Python language and the pillow module. I hope you enjoyed this project and I hope you learned the basics of image manipulation in Python in a fun way. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.